Good day, fellow investor. My name is Sven Karlin, and today I'll share with you an investment in the electric vehicle trend that is far better than Tesla and any other hyped electrical investment out there. Why am I not investing in Tesla? Well, Tesla first didn't turn a profit since ever. It's losing $20,000 per sold car. And all other car makers are coming to market with new electrical vehicles. We have Daimler, we have Hyundai, we have even Porsche coming out with new electrical models. So when there will be so much supply and everybody will be fighting for market share, what will happen? Margins will get squeezed. It will be very, very hard to turn a profit. And therefore, companies like Tesla and other electrical manufacturing companies will turn into normal car manufacturing stocks. Thus, they will do well in periods of economic expansion and they will do terribly in a recession. And that a recession is when you have to buy car manufacturing stocks if they won't go bankrupt. As we are now 8 years in an economic expansion, I wouldn't touch car stocks now. If cars aren't good, then how to play this electric vehicle trend? Then we can look at lithium or cobalt, that are the metals used in the batteries. However, if we look at the lithium price chart, we can see that it has already spiked up. I don't think this is because of increased demand for lithium, but this is speculators coming into the game and trying to push and make a buck on speculating on lithium price spikes. The same principle applies to cobalt, which has spiked in the last 12 months. Now, all these investments like Tesla, cobalt, lithium have enjoyed extreme price spikes in the last few years. This makes them very risky for low potential returns. This is something I don't like. What I like is an investment that's low risk, that I know will be in demand for the next decades, and that provides me high returns. An investment that is very related to the electric vehicle shift is copper. Plain, simple, old copper. So we don't know whether Tesla will make it, will become the biggest company, the new Apple, we don't know. Too risky for me. However, we know that there will be plenty new electrical vehicles in the world. We have the Tesla semi-truck coming. We have every car manufacturer coming to the market with new cars. On top of it, even petrolhead Jeremy Clarkson said about the BMW i8 that the car is utterly brilliant. So how does this play out for copper? First, an electric vehicle needs much more copper than a normal car with an internal combustion engine. Then there are other interesting developments. Electric buses that need 300 kilograms of copper per vehicle, and so on and so on. On top of it, we have Elon Musk showing to the world that a house will be completely electrically integrated with renewable energy. Solar tiles, batteries, chargers, cars, everything. What do you need to connect all the solar tiles? What do you need to connect the solar tiles to the inverter to the battery, to make the battery to the charger, and so on? What do you need? You need the best electrical conductor available, copper. So who will benefit the most? Currently profitable copper miners. There are some other already positive developments in the copper field that lower the risk. The International Copper Study Group forecasts copper deficits, supply-demand deficits, both in 2017 and in 2018. So this should keep copper prices stable in the short term, if not push them higher. The problem with copper, not if you're invested in it, is that the low-hanging fruit, the easy copper in the ground has been mined. What's left is copper, deeper underground and at a lower grade. This means that it will be more and more expensive to mine copper, which, if there will be higher demand for copper, should push copper prices significantly up. If we look at the copper supply-demand chart, we already see that current projects and probable projects are not enough to meet copper demand. And this copper demand chart excludes the electrical vehicle shift. In order to bring enough copper to the world, copper prices have to go up. When that happens, when demand for copper increases, who makes more profit? Copper miners. And currently positively operating copper miners, because their costs are fixed, they have their mines, their grades, they know what they're doing, and they're already profitable. When copper prices go up, their profits just increase. They don't have to do anything, their margins increase. The opposite of what will happen to Tesla and similar companies. What are the long-term forecasts for copper? Well, the World Bank's copper price forecast tells us that copper is going to increase by 30% up to 2030. And this is without the imminent shift to electric vehicles. So, if you want an investment that's less risky than Tesla or similar companies, that is an inevitable part of the renewable energy trend, clean energy, electrical vehicle, solar tiles, solar roofs, and everything that's related to that, developing India, developing China, electrical infrastructure, Germany banning internal combustion engines by 2030, you want to be invested in copper. And the best way are copper miners. Please subscribe, as in the next few days I will be discussing potential investments in copper miners, the risks and the rewards. So there will be plenty of added value in my future videos for those who are interested in a low risk, high return electrical trend, electrical vehicle investment. Thank you for watching. Leave your comments below, ask questions, and subscribe if you like. See you in the next video and have a great day.